Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and today I have a fun video where I will create 5 backgrounds using 5 different techniques. These are great for adding big sentiments on top of them and I have here 5 sentiments. These are from the new Glimmer Hot Foil Kit. You get 5 different sentiments. They are perfect for pretty much any occasion and if you love foiling on your cards, this is a great set to get. And here you can see the sentiments, a little note to say thanks, congrats on your special day, friends make everything better, the best is yet to come, and happy birthday and many more. I will be using all 5 of these sentiments on my cards today. Plus you will get black foil roll. This is shiny and it is great when you are working on colorful backgrounds and you want the sentiment to really stand out. And I know you're thinking that black is quite boring for foiling, but trust me, it is great. After all, we usually stamp our sentiments on top of cards with black. This is going to be shiny as well, and it's going to give that letterpress look. And of course, you will see this foiling in action today. Now, I will use 5 different techniques to create colorful backgrounds, and I will use these sentiments on top of them. However, keep in mind that you can use the same techniques to create backgrounds and then use any big stamp set or any big die sentiment that you have on your stash. For the first background, I'm going to use my alcohol inks and I'm working on Yupo paper. I'm going with 3 colors of alcohol ink and these are Pool, Aquamarine and Lime. This is 97% alcohol and I'm just using a pipette because it makes that job easy. I'm going to apply it all over the place, making sure that everything is nice and wet, since this is going to help the technique that I'm going for. Also notice that I'm working on my glass mat. This is going to make cleaning process later on super easy. Now I'm going to drop some ink. And this is easily movable just because I have alcohol underneath. Now I am going to use my heat gun. But remember that my heat gun is by Huawei and it has 2 settings. I'm not going to use the one that heats the paper or melts the embossing powder. I'm just using the one that dries. So this is just blows some air and I can move the ink. Remember that at any stage you can go ahead and add even more alcohol, which is going to make the ink run even more, or you can even add more ink if you want to, which is something that I'm going to do here. So once I'm happy with the background, I'm going to let aside, let it dry completely, and let's move on to another background. For my second technique, I'm going to go with watercolor, so I'm adding some water on the 2 colors that I will work with. Now I'm going to saturate the paper with lots and lots of water since I want this to be nice and airy. I'm going to apply the colors on top. I'm not going to cover up completely the whole white area and I will let the 2 colors blend together by leaving the water that I have underneath to do the hard job. Go ahead and make more background since you have your watercolors out. You can leave them aside to dry or just use your heat gun to speed up the drying process. For the next background technique, I'm going to do some ink blending. For that, I will use my new blending tools by Altenew. These have just been released and I like that they are big and they cover up completely a big area. Now I'm using my favorite color combo when it comes to backgrounds and this is Cracked Pistachio and Peacock Feathers. I'm going to blend those colors. I'm working on watercolor paper, by the way. And these oxide inks are a dream to work with. They blend beautifully together. So the process is really effortless and you can go ahead and create many, many more once you have your distress oxide inks out. So all you have to do later on is to just stick a sentiment on top and you have a card ready to go. Now, just to make it more interesting, I'm going to bring in a stencil. And I will go over the stencil again with the same colors. This technique is going to add some visual texture on the background, but at the same time it's going to keep it nice and subtle since I'm not introducing any new colors. Another way to add more interest and visual texture is to use a baby wipe over the stencil. This is going to activate the ink underneath and it's going to lift it. I'm not going to do that, but that's another idea. And finally, you can always add some water splashes. Let them activate the ink underneath for a few seconds and then blot it with a clean towel, which is going to give a lovely effect with splashes all over the place. It's going to lift ink from the paper. Now I'm going to leave this background aside and let's move on to another background. And this time I'm not going to create anything. I'm just going to use pattern paper that I have on my stash. This is a great way to use any pattern papers that you have that are really busy. Just cut out a rectangle that's 4.25 by 5.5, add a sentiment on top, and you are ready to go. I absolutely love this pattern paper. These are by Altenew. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm just going to cut out a panel and put it aside to turn it into a card later on. For the next technique, I'm going to use ink smoothing. This is a really fun technique. I am applying some distress oxide ink on top of my non-stick craft mat, then apply a little bit of water and smoothing the paper all over. I'm using my heat gun to dry this first layer. And then I will add a second layer, again by using the two colors that I had from the beginning. Of course, you can mix up even more inks and make it more colorful. The craft mat that I'm working on is the one that came with the glass mat, and it really makes a difference for this technique. The paper that I'm working on is watercolor paper. And now let's take a look at all the backgrounds that I created using all these different techniques. When you have a bunch of backgrounds so pretty as these ones, all you have to do is to just add a sentiment on top and let the background do the work for you. It can be a stamped sentiment, it can be a die-cut sentiment, or in my case, I will play with my foiling sentiments, which is going to add a sparkle and shine on my card and make them even more special. So I have a different sentiment for each and every one of these backgrounds, and I will use different foiling colors underneath just for the fun of it. Now I am going to make sure that this is not going to move on me, so I'm just taping it down with some washi tape. I am also going to cut out the corners just to make sure that I don't end up with too much over foiling, but I will share a few tips today on what you can do when something goes wrong. And you will see, I'm going to keep it real here, that lots of things are going to go wrong with my foiling, but everything is fixable. So now everything is down, and I went with silver for that background. For this one, I will go with gold. Every time I'm cutting out a piece of foil roll that is just about the size of my sentiment, so I don't have too much overfoiling all around, and I'm always taping it down to keep it from moving with some washi tape. Now notice I didn't cut out the corners here, and you will see later on why you have to cut them out. Now let's move on to the next one. For this one I'm going with black, just because I think this is the only color that it's going to show beautifully over that really bright background. For my blue and green background, I went with this wonderful foil. I absolutely love this one. So again, I'm going to cut out the corners here, and you will see I will end up with lovely foiling, and tape it down. The weather here in Greece is wonderful, and everyone is actually enjoying the weather on their yards, so you can probably hear the dogs barking or my neighbors mowing the lawn, but I have to keep my windows open because it's such a wonderful day. I have two of my backgrounds on my foiling machine. I'm running them through my die cutting machine, and I like to do that slowly. I place the platform back on the docking station so that it stays nice and warm for the next foiling. And let's take this out and see what happened. Now I'm going to lift this one, and probably you can tell that this is not perfect. I don't know if you can really see, but I'm going to show you that you can fix that later on. Now I'm going to peel off the foiling here, and this is perfectly done. I'm going to put this aside for now, and let's move on to the next two backgrounds. This time I'm going to place down the background with a smoothing technique, as well as the background with the pattern paper. And while this is warming up, I'm going to show you how you can fix something that didn't foil well. Now this machine doesn't only add foiling. It kind of creates a letterpress look, which means that it is embossed, the sentiment is embossed on the paper. I don't know if you can tell from this close-up here, but if you place the plate on top and you move it around, you will see that at some point it's going to click, it's going to fit inside that previous embossed area. So now I'm going to add some washi tape on top and create a hinge. Then I'm going to lift it and add underneath a piece of the same foil that I used. This is the shiny black one in this case. Meanwhile, the other two backgrounds were ready to go. So again, I'm running them through my die cutting machine. And now finally, I'm going to place the last two backgrounds, the one that I'm going to foil one more time, and the Yupo one. This is the first time I'm foiling on Yupo, and I was really curious to see if that is going to work or if it's going to warp the paper. Everything worked just fine. You can see that I'm running them through my die cutting machine here, and I'm going to peel off the foiling so you can see the results. The watercolor one is just perfect, and remember, this is the one where I had to foil twice. And here is the Yupo one. I just have some overfoiling in one letter, but I'm going to show you how to fix that. And the Yupo paper hasn't warped with the heat at all. So here are all the backgrounds that I created. This is the one with the watercolor where I had to do the foiling twice, and it was a great fix. You see, it looks wonderful. Here is the one with the Yupo where I have that overfoiling in this area, but I'm going to show you how to fix it in a moment. Here I have some overfoiling on the outside just because I didn't cut out the corners. So always cut out the corners, but I'm going to show you that this is fixable as well. And finally, on this one, the foiling isn't perfect, but I do have a messy background, so I'm going to embrace the mess on the foiling, and I think it matches perfectly with the background. So now, if you have some foiling in areas that you didn't mean to have, then just use a sand eraser and erase it completely, or if you need to be more precise, just use a craft knife and scratch it off, and no one will ever know. This is exactly what I did around the letter where I had that overfoiling. I did that scratching with my craft knife just because it is super pointy and I can go all around the difficult areas. And finally, I turned all of this into cards. I just stick every background on top of a 4.25 by 5.5. Here I have a lovely white flower and a few gems. In this one, I just added gems, nothing extra special here. Here, since this is for birthday, I just cut out a silver balloon, attached a white string, and my card is ready. For this one, I created a black border and cut out these leaves, added them on top at the bottom, and added some gems as well. And on the last one, I just added a few gold stars, just to embellish it a little bit more. Here you can see some close-up photos on all the 5 cards that I made for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Just like always, you will find a link to everything I used down below in the description area. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.